Good morning, boys. The previous class we have completed exercise 2.3, the fourth problem. Now we are going to see the fifth problem. You can refer the question from your book. The page number is 38. The fifth problem: the figure shown in the aerial view of the pathway, find the area of the pathway. Here they have given aerial. Aerial means from the air. From the air, we are going to see how the figure it is. So the figure they have given like this rectangle. This is outer rectangle, and then this is inner rectangle. They have mentioned this as 80 meter. Then this is 50 meter, 70 meter. Then 40 meter. So here find the area of the pathway. You have to find out this. This is the pathway. The pathway it is there. So we have to find the area of the pathway. We know that area of the rectangle is length into breadth. Here the length is 80 meter and breadth is 50 meter. So first area of the outer rectangle. Area of the outer rectangle is equal to capital L into B square units. So here they have given the length is 80 meter, length of the outer rectangle. So length of the outer rectangle is equal to is equal to 80 meter. Then breadth of the outer rectangle, you can use the shape also like this. Length of the outer rectangle is equal, breadth of the outer rectangle is equal to 50 meter. Hence area of the outer rectangle, area of the outer rectangle is equal to 80 into 50 is equal to 8 times 40. Here two zeros are there, you can add two zeros, so 4000 meters square. Then you have to find the area of the inner rectangle. So area of the inner rectangle is equal to, for inner rectangle you have to use small l, L into B square units. So the length of the inner rectangle they have given as 70 meter. Length of the inner rectangle is equal to small l is equal to 70 meter. Breadth of the inner rectangle, breadth of the inner rectangle is equal, B is equal to 40 meter. So hence we have to find the area of the inner rectangle. Area of the inner rectangle is equal to L into B square units. So this is equal to small l they have given 70 meter into 40 meter. This is equal to 7428. You can add two more zeros here. So 2800 meters square. We have to find out area of the pathway. So area of the pathway is nothing but area of the outer rectangle minus area of the inner rectangle. So area of the pathway is equal to area of the outer rectangle minus area of the inner rectangle.
So this is equal to, so area of the outer rectangle is 4000 minus inner rectangle is 2800. So you have to subtract these two things. So 4800 minus 4000 minus 2800. So 0, 0, you have to borrow 3, 1, 10 minus 8, 2, 3 minus 2, 1. So this is equal to 1200 meters square. Now we will go to the sixth problem. A rectangular garden has dimensions 11 meter into 8 meter. Here in the figure they have given a rectangular garden. The garden, it is in the rectangular shape. The garden they have given in the rectangular shape. That is 11 meter into 8 meter. So 11 meter is the length and 8 meter is the breadth. A path of 2 meter wide has to be constructed along its sides. So they have given the width they have given here. Wide means nothing but width. So width they have given as 2 meter. This side 2 meter, then here 2 meter. So the width they have given us 2 meter. So first we have to find the inner length and inner breadth. Okay. So for the area of the outer rectangle, they have given length of the outer rectangle. Length of the outer rectangle is equal to capital L is equal to 11 meter. Breadth of the outer rectangle, is equal to 8 meter. First we find out area of the outer rectangle. Area of the outer rectangle. So capital L into B square units. So this is equal to capital 11 into 8. 11 8 sir, 88 meters square. Now length of the inner rectangle is, length of the inner rectangle, we know that the formula is small l is equal to capital L minus 2w. So capital L minus 2w, that is the length of the inner rectangle. So the length they have given is 11 minus 2 into width is 2 meter. So you are going to substitute here. So 11 minus 4. So 11 minus 4 is nothing but 7 meter. So the area, length of the inner rectangle is 7 meter. Use the same method will be followed for area of the breadth of the inner rectangle. Breadth of the breadth of the inner rectangle is equal, b small b is equal to capital B minus 2W. Here, what is the capital B they have given? 8 meter. So, 8 minus 2 into 2. So, 8 minus 4. This is equal to 4 meter. Now, we have to find area of the inner rectangle. Area of the inner rectangle is equal to, area of the inner rectangle is equal to L into B square units. So this is equal to, L is nothing but 7, breadth is 4, so 7 4s are 28 meters square. Now area of the pathway. So, we have to find area of the pathway. So, area of the pathway is, we know that area of the outer rectangle minus area of the inner rectangle. Area of the outer rectangle minus area of the inner rectangle. So area of the outer rectangle, we have found out the area of the outer rectangle is 88 meters square. So 88 minus 28. If you subtract these two things, you will be getting 60 meters square. Your area of the meter square, square units, so we have to write meter square. Now, we will see the seventh problem. A picture is painted on a ceiling of a marriage hall whose length and breadth are 18 meter and 7 meter respectively. Here, a picture is painted on a ceiling of a marriage hall. So, length and breadth they have given. So, obviously, it is in the rectangle shape. So, the ceiling painted on a ceiling of a marriage hall. The marriage hall, the ceiling of the marriage hall, it is in the rectangle shape. So, here 18 meter is the length and 7 meter is the breadth. There is a border of 10 centimeter along each of its sides. So, the border, this is the border. So 10 centimeter they have given. 10 centimeter is the width. 10 centimeter. This is also 10. This is also 10. So here you have to observe that the outer rectangle, length of the rectangle and the breadth of the rectangle, they have given the units in the meter. But the width they have given us, the border they have given us centimeter. First, you should change this into meter. So, first thing, W width is, we know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay. So, we have to convert this into meter. So, 10 centimeter is equal to 10 by 100 meter. So, you can cancel these two zeros. 1/10 is equal to 0.1 meter. So the width is equal to W. See, width is equal to 0.1 meter. So now we are going to find a length of the outer area of the outer rectangle. So length of the outer rectangle length of the ceiling, you can write ceiling, length of the ceiling capital L is equal to 18 meter. Breadth of the ceiling, breadth of the ceiling capital B is equal to 7 meter. So area of the ceiling, area of the ceiling is equal to, we know that L into B, square units. So what is L? 18. What is B? 7. So 18 sevens are 126 meters square. Then we have to find length of the ceiling, length of the ceiling without border. So length of the ceiling without border we have to find. Since this is the border, without the border we are going to find. So without border, that is small l, is equal to, so capital L minus 2W. So capital L is 18 minus 2 into W is width, we have found out 0.1. So this is equal to 18 minus 0.2. So this is equal to 18 minus 0.2 is 17.8 meter. Then we have to find breadth of the ceiling without border. Without border is equal to small b, is equal to capital B minus 2W. So capital B is 7 minus 2 into 0.1. The value of width is 0.1. So 7 minus 0.2. So 7 minus 0.2 is 6.8 meter. Now we have to find area of the ceiling without the border. Area of the ceiling. Area of the ceiling without border is equal to, so area of the ceiling, L into B, square units. So L is small l, we have found out 17.8 into 6.8. So you have to multiply 17.8 into 6.8. So shall I will multiply here. It's a 17.8, 6.8. 8 8s are 64, 6, 56, 56 plus 6, 2, 62, 8, 8 plus 6, then 14, then 8, 6 8s are 48, 4, 42, 42 plus 4, 46, 4, 6 plus 4, 10. So 4, 0, 1, 10, 11, 1, 2, 1. So here the two decimal point, after the decimal point, two digits are there. So you have to count from the right to left. Two digits we have to count, 1, 2. So we have to keep the point here. So 121.04 meters square. Now we have to find area of the pathway, area of the border. So area of the border, area of the border is equal to, so area of the ceiling minus area of the ceiling without border. So area of the ceiling minus area of the ceiling without border. So area of the ceiling, we have found out how much it is, 126 meters square, minus area of the ceiling without the border is 121.04. So you have to subtract these two things, 126, 121. For here 0.04 they have given, so we can have 0.00, and we can subtract these two things. So we have to borrow here. So 5 here, it will become 10. So 9 10. So 10 minus 4 6 9. 5 minus 1 4, here 0 0. So the value is 4.96 meters square. Eighth problem, a canal of width 1 meter is constructed all along inside the field, which is 24 meter long and 15 meter wide. A canal of width 1 meter, here it is in the canal, it is a canal of width 1 meter is constructed all along inside the field. So we will take this as a field. It is the field, it is in the rectangle shape. So constructed along here 24 meter long and then 15 meter wide. The field, it is in the rectangle shape. Inside that, for 1 meter width, they have constructed a, here the canal, it is there. So this is 1 meter. So all the sides it is 1 meter. So 1 meter. So what we have to find out? area of the outer rectangle and then area of the inner rectangle, we have to find area of the canal. So area of the canal is area of the outer field minus area of the inner field. We will be getting the area of the inner thing. Then after finding the area, one more thing they have given, the cost of constructing the canal at the rate of rupees 12 per square meter. We have to find the cost also, how much cost it takes place. So first thing, we are going to find area of the field. So area of the field is equal to capital L into B square units. So the capital L is 24 meter into 15 meter. So you have to multiply 24 into 15. So 5 fours are 20, 2, 10, 12, 4, 2, 0, 6, 3. So 360 meter square. So now we have to find length of the field without canal. Length of the field without canal. So small l is equal to capital L minus 2W. So capital L is 24 minus 2 into the width they have given us 1. So 24 minus 2 ones are 2. So 24 minus 2 is 22 meter. The same way you have to find for the breadth. So breadth of the field without canal. So small b is equal to capital B minus 2W. So capital B is 15 minus 2 into 1. So 15 minus 2 is equal to 13 meter. Now we have to find area of the field without canal. Area of the field without canal is equal to L into B square units. So the small L is nothing but 22 into 13. So you have to multiply these two things, 22 into 13. 3 twos are 6, 2, 2. So 6, 8, 2. So 286 meter square. Now we have to find the first question they have asked in the question is area of the canal. Area of the canal is equal to area of the canal is area of the field minus area of the field without canal. So area of the field minus area of the field without canal. So area of the field is 360 meter square minus area of the field without canal is 286 meter square. We have to subtract these two things. So 360, 286. Borrow here 5, it will become 10. 4, 2, 15, 15 minus 8,
74 meter square. So this is the solution. Now here the cost of for the second question, the first question they have given, for the second question the cost of constructing the canal, the cost of constructing the cost of constructing the canal for 1 meter square is rupees 12. So we have to find for 74 meter square cost of constructing the canal for, we found out 74. So 74 meter square is equal to, so 74 into 12. So if you multiply 74 into 12, 4 2 are 8, 7, 14, 4, 7, 8, 8, 8. So therefore the cost of constructing the canal for 74 meter square is equal to rupees 888. Now we will see the objective type questions. The formula to find the area of the circular path is, so they have given four options, they have given pi, r square minus r square, square units. Then the second one, pi r square, square units. Third one, 2 pi r square, square units. So fourth one, pi r square plus 2 r square units. We know that the circular, the formula for the circular pathway, we have done so many problems. The formula is pi r square minus r square square units is the correct answer. Option number 1 is the correct one. Then this is 9th problem. Then 10th one, the formula used to find area of the rectangular pathway. So area of the rectangular pathway is area of the outer rectangle minus area of the inner rectangle. So area of the outer rectangle is L into B, the second one. So capital L into B minus, this is area of the outer rectangle minus area of the inner rectangle, small L into B, square units. So then the third one, 11th one, the formula to find the width of the circular pathway. So when you find out the width of the circular pathway, we know that capital R minus small r. So circular pathway W is equal to capital R minus small r. That is the width of the circular pathway. This is R minus R units. The third option is the correct one. So these are the, we have completed this. So exercise 2.3 we have completed, boys. So whenever, one more thing I want to insist to you. So whenever you are solving the problem, after completing you have to draw the line for each and every problem. Then the date is important. So while you are solving, You just read the question 2 times, what they have given and what is the formula for that, and then what you have to find out. These 3 main things it is there in the statement problem. So after each and every problem, draw the line, and then the date is important. We are completing this exercise 2.3. We are going to see the new chapter, algebra. In the algebra, exponential and powers. The chapter topic name is exponential and powers. Introduction. If a is any integer, then a into a into a up to a n times, then that is equal to a power n. Here a is the base and n is the exponent or power. We can hear a is the base or n it is in the power or exponent. We call this a as a base and n it will be in the exponent or power. Here this method of expressing a number is called exponential form. So the exponential form it will be in a power n. So a is the base and n is the power. Here for example, if you take 16 is equal to, you know how to do the factorization method. In 6th standard you have learned the factorization, prime factorization method. 16, if you divide by 2 you will be getting 8, then 2, then 4, then 2, 2. So how many times? 4 times it is there. So 16 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Now you can write what is the power here. Power is whenever the number is not given, you have to assume it as 1. So 1, 1, 1. So how many 2s are there? 4 2s are there. So that we are mentioning here. This is the power. So it can be read as, how you can read this one? 2 to the power of 4, you can read this as 2 to the power of 4 or 2 raised to the power 4. 2 to the power of 4 you can read, or you can read it as 2 raised to the power of power 4, or in simple form 2 power 4. 2 power 4. So when the exponent is usually written, exponent is usually written at the right corner. Here this is the right corner in smaller size. The exponent, for example 2 power 4 it is there. This exponent it will be written in the right corner in a small letter, small number. Then the base it will be the bigger number. So the base and the smaller in size, and when compared to the base, while you are comparing to the base and exponent, the exponent, the power it will be written in the smaller size, the base will be written in the larger size. So 2 power 4, 2 is the base and 4 is the exponent. So how you will read this 2 raised to the power or 2 power 4? So then another important thing, when a number is expressed as a product of factors, for example here the 16 it is there. When a number is expressed as a product of factor, this is the 2 is the factor. What you have done? It is the product. Product is nothing but multiplication. When a number is expressed as the product of factor, 2 into 2 into 2. So when a number is expressed as a product of factor, and when the factor are repeated, here what it happened? It is repeatedly the same number. So 2, 2, 2, 2. There is no other number at all. The same number it is there. So when the factor are repeated, then it can be expressed in the exponential form. So when a number it is in the factor form, it is in the product form, the repeated factors, then only we can write in the exponential form. Otherwise we can't write in the exponential form. So when a number is expressed as a product of factor, so for 16 if we take, so this is 2 into 2 into 2. So it should be in the product of the factor form. When the factors are repeated, these factors are repeated with the same number, then we can write it in the exponential form. Another important thing, the repeated factors will be the base. So the repeated factor. So here, which is the repeated factor? 2 is the repeated factor. So 2 is the base. So 2 is the base. The repeated factor will be the base. And the number of times of the factor repeats will be its exponent. So the number of times, how many times it repeated? 4 times it was repeated. So this is the exponent. So hence this point is the repeated factor will be the base, and the number of times it will be repeated, that it will be the exponent. So this is the main thing. If it is in the negative form, minus whole power n, if 1 is n, is even natural number, then it will be an even natural number. Then if it is minus 1, then if n is odd natural number, so if it is an odd natural number, the value will be negative. If it is an even natural number, the value will be positive. The remaining thing we will see in the next class, boys. Thank you so much.